What's up everybody, Brad here. In this video, I'm gonna walk you through setting up the Mini DSP 2x4 HD, as well as installing and configuring the software that's included with it so you can start tweaking your subwoofers. Does that sound good? Then let's go. Now, I do wanna say right off the bat that I paid for the Mini DSP 2x4 HD with my own money. This is not a sponsored video, and in fact, Mini DSP hasn't returned any of my emails, which is probably because I never sent them one. However, SVS was super awesome and let me borrow a second PB2000 Pro subwoofer in order to make producing these videos a bit easier. So a huge thanks goes out to them. And yes, I did say videos. This is actually the first part of a multi-part series of videos regarding the Mini DSP 2x4 HD. As I said, this video will focus on the physical install of the Mini DSP unit, as well as installing and configuring the software. The next video will be going through subwoofer setup, time alignment, and EQ, with subsequent videos focusing on refining the EQ curve, time aligning your subwoofers with your main speakers, and figuring out the perfect crossover for not only your system, but also your room. And I do want to give a shout out to a couple of YouTube channels, Home Theater Gurus and CEO Guy Stuff. These guys have been invaluable when it comes to learning the ropes with the Mini DSP, and without their videos, it would have taken me a lot longer to figure this stuff out. If you have the chance, go over and show their channel some love. Also, if you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing as I post new home theater and gaming related content every week. And if you'd like to help the channel out, consider using my Amazon affiliate links in the description below. You don't even have to buy the link thingy that you clicked on. You can literally buy anything else within 24 hours and I still get a commission. With that out of the way, let's get the Mini DSP set up, installed, and configured. So this is the Mini DSP 2x4 HD. Now most of you will be familiar with this item since you're watching this video, but basically it allows you to set up multiple subwoofers, get them playing nicely together, and then apply a global EQ to get the response you want in your room. It has two inputs and four outputs and can be used with speakers, not just subwoofers, but that's a topic for another day. Before you hook this thing up, turn off all your subwoofers so you don't get that great buzzing sound we all love to hear when you're plugging the cable in. Plug the subwoofer output from your receiver or pre-pro into N1 on the Mini DSP and disable any other subwoofer outputs if your receiver has them. Now plug each of your subwoofers into the outputs of the Mini DSP, starting with out one. I have three subs, so I'll plug each one in and make a note of what cable goes to which sub, and this will come in handy later. Once you're done with that, go ahead and attach the power cable and plug it in. Hook up the USB cable that came in the box to the Mini DSP, but don't plug it into the computer just yet. You may want to consider getting a USB extension cable if your computer is really far from the Mini DSP. Now let's download the software. For that, you'll need to create a free account at minidsp.com. If you bought your Mini DSP directly from this site, then your software should be ready to download by clicking on the arrow by your user icon, then selecting user downloads. If you bought your Mini DSP from a third-party seller like Amazon, then it should have come with the code inside the box. Head to minidsp.com/support/redeem-coupon and enter your code. Again, you'll need to create an account if you don't have one yet. Then, like before, click the arrow next to your user icon and go to user downloads. From here, select the Mini DSP plugins at the top, then select the Mini DSP 2x4 HD plugins under the category section. Download the file, locate it, and unzip it. Find the plugins folder and select your OS. For me, I'm using Windows, so I'll install from there and just stick with the default installation settings. Next, plug in the USB cable from the Mini DSP to your computer. Find the Win drivers folder within the Mini DSP folder and install the correct driver. I'm using Windows 10, so for me, it's the second one. Once you're done, go ahead and launch the Mini DSP plugin, and if a Windows firewall notification pops up, make sure only the box next to Private Networks is ticked. With the software open, click the Connect button in the upper right-hand corner, otherwise anything you change here won't actually sync with the Mini DSP. Once connected, you can minimize this little window, but don't close it. It should default to the Inputs and Routing tab, and from here, we need to tell the Mini DSP what inputs and outputs we're using. Typically, you can just leave the input section on the left at default, but make sure that the signal is set to analog, otherwise your subs won't get a signal at all. For the routing section, we can disable output 3 and output 4 in the second row, as that's for input 2, which we aren't using. For the top row, which is input 1 that we are using, we want to make sure that the outputs are turned on and say 0 dB for the subs we plugged up. For me, I plugged in three subs, so I want output 1, 2, and 3 of the top row to all say 0 dB. If you only have two subs plugged in, then you just want the first two outputs enabled. Four subs, all four enabled. You get the idea. Now head over to the Outputs tab. By default, the Mini DSP is set up for use with speakers and have crossovers activated, which we want to disable as we're only using these for subwoofers. So under Output 1, click on Xover and make sure both high pass and low pass filter settings say bypassed. Now tick the box next to Link and select Output 2. This links both Xover settings together so they're now synced. If you have more than two subwoofers, you'll have to do the same for outputs 3 and 4, except you can't link them with either output 1 or 2. It's best to simply link output 3 with output 4. So I'll select Xover under output 3, bypass both filters, tick the box next to link, and select output 4. Now these are synced with each other. If you made a note of which cables go to which subs, then you can label them here, which will make it easier to keep track when doing level adjustments and time alignment. Finally, go ahead and save this configuration by choosing File in the upper left, selecting Save, and naming it. This way, you'll always be able to revert to these settings. And that's it. Your Mini DSP is all set up and ready to go. Now, don't forget to turn your subs back on after everything's hooked up and turned on. I probably should have mentioned that sooner, but hey. Look for a video next week where I walk through time alignment and EQ. Now, if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful at all, please give it a thumbs up as it really helps support the channel. Also, if you have any questions about the things covered in this video, leave me a comment down below and let me know. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one where I end up hacking into a government computer system for more power and end up creating a real woman from a doll.
Why are we wearing bras on our heads?
Ceremonial.